thank you very much for that kind introduction. I want to begin by conveying the congratulations of my boss, and I will do that by reading a letter from the president, dated this date, June 7, 2010. I send my congratulations to this year's winners of the Mathematical Association of America's U.S.A. Mathematical Olympiad. America's future depends on our ability to remain the world's engine of scientific discovery and technological innovation. To prepare our young people to lead, we must give them a world-class education that challenges them to meet the demands of the 21st century. Mathematics is an essential tool that enables achievements in a wide range of fields, from science and engineering to architecture and economics. Competitions like the USAMO promote excellence in our students, and this year's winners can take pride in the hard work and determination that it took to reach this moment. Your talent, commitment, and perseverance will serve you well in your future careers and will prepare you as you steer our nation's course as the next generation of American leaders. I wish you all the best for continued success in the years to come, and it's signed, Barack Obama. Let me add my congratulations to the presidents, to the 12 winners of the 39th USA Math Olympiad, and to your parents and your teachers. And I'll say a little more about them in a moment. The dozen of you winners are the cream of our young mathematics talent in this country. Your attainment makes you role models for all that we would love to be able to achieve in science and math education at the K-12 level in this country. The president has said repeatedly that science, technology, engineering, and math education are among his highest priorities. I have heard him say that the single most important thing we can do for the future of our country is to raise the level of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics education in this country from preschool to grad school and indeed lifelong. And the president understands that it's important to do that not just to train the next generation of Nobel laureates and winners of national medals of science and national medals of technology and innovation and the great math prizes that are out there. That's important. And you winners, you 12 winners, can certainly aspire to the highest in the way of achievement going forward. But we also need to lift the level of science and math education in this country in order to have the technology-savvy workforce that we will need to be competitive in the 21st century and the science-savvy citizenry that we will need to be an effective, functioning democracy in a society where more and more of the policy issues for our leaders have science and mathematics content. So for all these reasons, we are so proud of the dozen of you who have won this year's USA Math Olympiad as role models, as leaders, as examples of what we need to aspire to. The commitment and perseverance that you have already shown in reaching this remarkable level of attainment will certainly serve you well. Whether you go on to be mathematicians, as some of you certainly will, or to pursue related fields in science, economics, or other domains, or even if you end up doing something entirely different. But for now, we are immensely proud of you for what you've already achieved. We also know, of course, that you didn't do this entirely on your own. So I want to say to your teachers, some of whom I know are here tonight, we know that these accomplishments of these 12 came in part through your hard work, through your dedication, and through your capacity to inspire. Probably nothing more important in our teaching system than the capacity of our teachers to inspire young people to reach their potential. And so I want to thank you again, not only on my own behalf, but on behalf of the president for all that you do. We just released today the names of this year's winners of the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science Teaching. And as far as I'm concerned, all of you who contributed to the education of these brilliant young mathematicians we celebrate tonight are deserving of presidential accolades for that contribution. And I know that the president, who would love to have greeted you all himself, but for the character of his current schedule, which is rather demanding to say the least, would want me to say that we are as grateful to the teachers as we are to the students whose enormous achievements led to this pinnacle. And of course the parents, certainly not least. Your care and interest, your love and support is what has made the dreams of your kids possible, made them a reality. Your role in your children's success cannot be overstated. And just as your kids, these magnificent winners of these awards, are role models, so are you as parents role models that we hope other parents will imitate going forward, because we need the contributions of parents inspiring their kids, enabling their kids, letting them know that whatever they want to achieve, they can achieve with hard work and dedication and focus. I do want to say that in the interest of full disclosure, this administration has a special appreciation for the Math Olympiad, because a former winner of the Math Olympiad, Eric Lander, who's now at the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard, is one of my co-chairs of the President's Council of Advisors on Science and Technology, which is a high-level brain trust which ensures that the President has the best and smartest interpretations of the scientific, technological, and mathematical, and indeed statistical realities that underpin the policy decisions that he has to make. Of course, I can't promise tonight's winners that you'll all end up advising a president of the United States, but I suspect that one or more of you might. And if you do, I want to warn you, there is a lot of hard work involved. Being science advisor president, being a member of the President's Council of Advisors on Science and Technology is not a 40-hour week job, it's more like a 100-hour week job. But I will also tell you, should any of you aspire to work ultimately on the boundary of science and mathematics and public policy, that it is the most rewarding job out there, in my judgment. I can't think of anything that I would rather be doing than advising this president on this set of issues at this particular moment. Of course, it is a great benefit that we have a president who understands with crystal clarity how important science and mathematics and engineering are to the whole array of challenges that we face in our society today, from the economy to healthcare to energy to climate change to national security, cybersecurity, information technology, broadband. Whatever issue is on the president's agenda, it turns out that science and math and engineering are going to be important to meeting the challenge, solving the problems, and raising the level of well-being in our society going forward. Probably most of you in the room are well aware of Galileo's formulation, his great exhortation, namely that the great book of nature can be read only by those who know the language in which it was written, and that language is mathematics. Those of you who we're honoring here tonight have proven yourselves to be remarkably fluent in that most important and foundational of all languages, the language of mathematics. You've become young masters of an extraordinary, essential, and I think you'll all agree, very beautiful tool for understanding the world, understanding the universe, a tool that has an essential role to play in virtually every discipline across science, technology, social sciences, architecture, design, art, and music. The mathematical underpinnings are important and indispensable. Your fluency in mathematics puts you in a truly privileged position, because not everyone will be able to master this most fundamental language. You have a position of access not only to the answers to practical problems, but to a universe that is filled with mysteries and profound abstractions to which mathematics holds the key. You have earned really a magnificent opportunity. So I wish you all a spectacular voyage as you continue your studies. I know you will go far, And for now, please enjoy your evening, revel in your success, and good luck to all of you in the next phase of this competition. Thanks very much.